Right, guys, there it is. It has been exactly 1 year since the Newcastle United takeover. Exactly 1 year since I stood here with so many other Newcastle fans and celebrated the change in Newcastle United. It's crazy to think that a year has gone by already. So much has changed. On that night, so much changed. No more boycotting, no more protesting. The community of Newcastle came back together, and over the year we've had changes to the ground, St James's Park, it's Shearer's Bar again. So much has changed, and that's not even mentioning the 200 million spent on transfers. So I thought, you know what, I'm going to come back, stand in the same place 1 year later and give another cheers to the owners for coming in to Newcastle United. So much has changed for the better. Oh, I got stick for Foster's last time as well, so I'm sure I'll get it again. But I had to get the same can. Cheers, everyone. Enjoy it. And I will say as well, thank you to all of you lot for the great support that I've had over the last year. The channel has gone from strength to strength with the videos since the takeover. And I'm hoping to see even more over the next few years. This is the tip of the iceberg. The owners have said just this week that it is just the start. And I cannot wait to see what happens next. If you are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe, and I have put a few clips together of everything that has happened over the last year. So enjoy it. Thanks for watching, guys. And I'll catch you later.
Today is the day Newcastle fans return to St James's Park to watch Premier League. We are taking on West Ham. We played them first game of the season last season and won. So I'm hoping we can maybe do that again today.
Time 4-2. Welcome back. Here we go. Come on, Newcastle. Come on, finish. It was end to end, I suppose, in the end. If we'd won that game, it would have been an absolute smash and grab, because we were not good today.
Look, today we are going to see Newcastle take on Manchester United at Old Trafford. And it is obviously the day Ronaldo returns to the Premier League. I can possibly see Ronaldo getting a hat-trick, if I'm honest. But fingers crossed we can turn up and give it a good go.
Finally, the Newcastle United supporters have got what they have wanted for a long, long time. For 18 months of this takeover saga, for 14 years of Mike Ashley's stewardship, the Premier League statement, which we've been waiting for all day long, has just landed.
Come on! Get in! It is officially done. The Premier League have now officially tweeted about it. Sky Sports have tweeted about it. Literally in the last second, everyone has come out and said the deal is finally done.
Oh, it's good now.
First can, the new era.
Please, 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 give a huge joy welcome to our new chairman, Yeah. bit of breaking news to bring you. Newcastle United Football Club have sacked their manager, Steve Bruce.
Way overdue. We have not won a game yet this season. He's won 7 games in 38 matches. Regardless of whether we had a takeover or not, he should have been gone ages ago.
Eddie Howe is the new manager at Newcastle. They have confirmed him, in fact, as new head coach on a contract until summer 2024.
It feels fantastic to be head coach of Newcastle. I'm absolutely honoured, privileged. It's an incredible moment in my life.
I am very happy that this is finally done and dusted.
Today, Newcastle are taking on Burnley at St James's Park. 3 o'clock kickoff, and Newcastle are still looking for their first win of the season.
What a window for Newcastle United. Their first under their new owners. Kieran Trippier was joined by Bruno Guimaraes, Chris Wood, Matt Target and Dan Byrne, taking their spending to more than £90 million.
If you asked me about the Everton Newcastle game at the start of the season, I would have gone, whatever. But we're now in a position where Newcastle can exit the relegation zone today if they win and pull Everton within 1 point.
Newcastle take on Brighton at St James's Park. Newcastle looking to extend their unbeaten run from 7-8. Currently 4 wins and 5, taking on a Brighton side who have lost the last 3 games. Tonight we are heading up to St James's Park to see Newcastle take on Arsenal for the final home game of the season. And what a season it's been for Newcastle, the first team ever not to win any of the opening 14 matches and still able to secure safety in the Premier League.
We've had all season. We did our job this season. We already stayed up. But how much of a cherry on the cake would it have been to win tonight? What a summer it's going to be. Cannot wait for the future of this club.